It's time for the Giz Wiz with Mad's maddest writer, Dick DeBartolo. This is episode 1598, recorded Wednesday, November 23rd, 2016. Remotely interesting. On this episode of the Giz Wiz, Dick looks into the future to see what will be at CES 2017. It's the last of my crappy corner gadgets for under $5 and a gadget that I have to have in the letter. All coming up next on the Giz Wiz!
It's the same show with Dickie D and OMG chat on your PC. It's time for the Giz Wiz because gadgets are his business. They've got a gizmo sickness, geek disease,
a nerd pathology.
Rows and rows of USBs, growing LEDs. Get ready for the Giz Wiz now.
Now it's time for the Giz Wiz. And here he is, the author of the Giz Wiz Almanac, Dick DeBartolo. How you doing, Dickie D?
I'm doing fine, sir. And you?
Doing good. Doing very good. They don't really write almanacs for stuff that often anymore, do they?
No.
I remember the tech almanac.
Yes.
I don't do that anymore.
You know, I even wonder if you could sell a tech book these days only because you can find everything online.
Right. The only thing that I feel like the niche is still available is like programming books.
Oh, okay.
Like a programming language. Those books,
right.
O'Reilly has always made those books forever. Sure, they'll keep making those books.
Yeah.
No, Dennis is kind of nice to have a physical.
Dennis happens to like books, like when he was learning Illustrator. I said, Dennis, there are about 90 million videos on how to use Illustrator. And he bought several books because he likes having the book open.
Yeah, definitely.
While he's on there. Yeah, I get around that. But since I have four computers, so basically I bring up YouTube on one computer while I'm working on the other, so I can keep stopping it. And he goes, so the first thing you should do is this. So I stop
Pause.
The YouTube, and I do it, and then I go back.
I have multiple monitors for that.
Yes, exactly. Exactly.
Right. Golly. Yeah. I don't think they do those that often. Farmer's Almanac is still a thing, says my tallest. And I guess that makes sense, too. Maybe if you're on a farm, it's hard to get, cell phone service and things like that. But I remember going through my book collection and seeing Tech Gadget Almanac for, 1997. They don't do that anymore.
It's
perfectly done by blogs, in fact.
Yes, and daily.
Oh, yeah, all the time.
Yeah.
All the time. And before I buy a product, all the time nowadays, Best TV 2016, is what you'll Google. So you find some good stuff that way.
Yeah, no, absolutely. And sometimes also on reviews on Amazon, I often find things like I go, can I hook this to a thing to hook it to that to hook it to this? And often someone will say, oh, I tried that. You can't do that.
No, it didn't work. Didn't work.
Yeah, it didn't work.
Right.
So it does save time. But also the other thing on Amazon is very funny is someone said, this is the best. You just put it on the shelf. You turn the knob and it's fine. And then the person under it says, don't waste your money. This does not work. The instructions I know. And I go,
did you guys get the same product shipped to you? That's what I always wonder.
Exactly. That's why, as we talked about, if you get something with 500 reviews and 400 of them are either 4 or 5 stars, you know that you're going to be happy with it.
Right.
Unless you get some bomb.
Right.
But when you're down to 20 and it's iffy.
Right, exactly. And still no one has, exactly. So, awesome. Well, I guess let's jump into some gadgets.
Let's jump in. Okay, as you said in the intro, there's an event in New York just took place called CES Unveiled, where CES looks at gadgets that are going to be at CES 2017. And they actually award the Innovation Awards that day in November. And the reason was It is rather. I often wondered how could you go to CES and people have plaques on the counter that says we won the 2017 Innovation Award for phones that fit in a shirt pocket? And I go, well,
how do you know that? How did you make put that on your booth?
I know. The show just opened an hour ago. So that's the deal. They hand out the awards in November so that people can print and make signs and get all the benefit of it by the time CES rolls around. So the first thing we're going to look at is Smart Remote from 7Hugs.
Hey, Dick DeBartolo, Mad's Maddest Writer in the Giz Wiz. One take theater here at gizwiz.tv. This is CES, and this is the preview of CES 2017, and we're at 7Hugs. What is 7Hugs?
7Hugs, so it's a company we started 3 years ago, and we wanted to focus on technology easy to use for anyone in the home, so especially people that are not tech-savvy and children, and bringing very useful and simple devices in the home.
Okay, and in the form of a remote, right?
Yeah, so this is our second product, actually. We already have a first product. This is our second one, which really changed the game for a smart home. It's very simple to use and lets you actually control anything in your home just by pointing at it. You just need to point, and the screen of a remote adapts automatically.
Can I pick out something? Like, can I pick out that lamp?
Yeah, so you can point at the lamp.
Okay. Can you do it?
Oh, yeah, sure. I can show you demos. So.
Okay. We're going to aim it at something, and...
So you have here, we are controlling the Samsung TV, and because there is a light just next to the TV, I can also control the light. So I'm controlling the light, changing the color.
So when you hit the light is in control. When you hit the picture of the TV, you're controlling the TV?
Yeah. When two devices are close to each other, the remote automatically proposes a carousel. So you can switch from TV to light very easily on sliding on top of the remote.
Now, a TV has like a million controls on it. When you go to TV, what options come up?
Yeah, so
I'm going to step in front of this slide.
Yeah, so this is a prototype unit, so the screen will be much bigger. On this unit, what we did is we allow have several menus by scrolling, but on the final product, it's all going to be available on one screen.
So no codes or anything? It automatically sort of knows what it is?
Well, what you need to do is when you add device, you use the smartphone to add your devices. And then you use the remote to locate them.
I see.
So you place the remote next to the device, press the locate button, and then the remote knows exactly where the device is in space. And every time you point at it, it will adapt the screen.
Okay. And so is it going to be like this big when you're done?
Yeah. Yeah. This is the final unit. So this is going to be big like that, together with a screen which goes from here to here.
Okay. And what will this retail for?
So retail price will be $299, but we just launched the product on Kickstarter today. It has been doing extremely well. The first batches went in a few hours, and right now it's at $149, and we have $179 and $199, and it's going to be at retail at $299.
Okay, and you expect it to be in the marketplace? By
we'll ship in June 2017. This is when we'll ship the product.
Okay, great. Okay, that's 7Hugs. That'll be coming out in 2017. This is a preview look, and we're here at CES Innovations. Dick DeBartolo, Mads Maddest Writer, and the Giz Wiz with Simon. Simon, thanks so much.
Thank you very much.
Okay, we're gonna find more stuff. Bye.
Bye. Thank you.
I can't wait till 2018 when it becomes 8Hugs. That'll be very exciting.
Yes, someone in the chat room said, wait, did we say that before? Yes, they introduced this. This is how long products take actually get to the market, especially this is actually a kind of complicated product. So they introduced it in 2016. And now they are, you want to go to 7Hugs because they wanted 50,000. And I think it was last,
at $684,000.
So they picked up another $34,000 wow. in 24 hours. Okay.
Wow. Well, but, wait a second. This is it says that their goal was $50,000.
Yes.
So they
right.
picked up $630,000.
Wow. Yes, they are like 50 times I can't do good math, but
right.
they're more than 12 yeah, more than 12 times or 13 times more than what they wanted. But it's very complicated because he didn't talk about it, and I didn't find out about it until this is good that you're showing that video. Is the remote comes with three sensors that go in on three different walls.
Oh,
and then when you put the device next to a thing that you're going to control, it sends the information to the sensor where in the room it is.
Okay.
So it's not like there's a little camera in there that says, oh, I see a TV. It actually maps the room and maps where each gadget is.
Okay, that makes sense. Because I was definitely trying to figure out, how is this going to work in every home that you know that you're pointing the remote at a specific point in the room? Is it going to just use a compass? Is it going to use some sort of like super locating GPS? I couldn't figure that out.
I think it has GPS, and I think it has, for some reason, accelerometer. It has a lot of stuff in it.
If you have three of their own built sensors inside of a room, that makes so much more sense that they're using the telemetry data that it's getting. It has its own built-in sensors in that thing to figure out where it is.
That's exactly right. And as you said, he called the carousel is going to be at the top, where if three gadgets are near each other, then you just scroll across. You want the lamp, you want
right.
the TV, whatever. But also,
and this also makes sense that it is per room. It isn't the entire home. It is whichever room you decide to put the sensors into. That's the one that you can point at things and get it to know that what you're pointing at.
Yes. So. However, it's very complicated. He said it's so easy.
Oh, it's so simple.
Is the other rooms, if it's a Wi-Fi enabled device, it will work when you point it out the door, because it's on the Wi-Fi system, not on Bluetooth that may not reach into the other room. It also can even send out IR signals if the remote you're replacing communicates with the device via infrared. So, it's really quite remarkable.
Yeah, I agree. I mean, it looks like you can do IR, Wi-Fi, and that's
Bluetooth. Right.
Wow, interesting.
And they're adding new things like aim it out the window and you get the weather.
Oh, that's interesting. So you can just, instead of that's interesting.
Yeah.
So maybe
aim
you have a device that's like not in the room. Yeah, that's cool to have almost like a hotspot. Okay, this is my hotspot for this.
Yes. Aim it at the front door and it calls an Uber car.
Interesting.
So they're now adding services. So when he said it's going to be very easy, I don't think so.
Right. I mean, after initial setup.
It'll
be the easiest thing in the world, right?
Absolutely. Somebody
where you want.
Somebody like kind of techie will set it up.
Right.
And then they'll just say, aim it at the TV, and the biggest screen is going to have a lot more of the controls right on a single screen, so you don't have to go through a bunch of screens. Originally, they were going to make it small, and then they started asking people, and they go, we don't want that little thing where you're going to have to scroll through dozens of menus. Give us a bigger thing where a lot of selections can be on the remote. So they went from the big one that they originally showed to a little small prototype, which people didn't like, and now they're back to a bigger remote with a bigger screen. So,
man, that's incredible. I can't imagine building something like this, because it shows what it's compatible with, and I don't understand.
Yes.
Holy mackerel, that would be so difficult to come up with all that stuff.
No, absolutely.
And
absolutely.
On top of building a product, it's like you'd have to have two teams.
Yeah, yeah.
One
25
just to
more.
Make it compatible, the other one to make the actual product.
Yeah.
Holy
cow. Right now, it's compatible with more than 25,000 devices.
Wow.
And yeah, it's ingenious.
I mean, it really shows that we need a just one database, one platform that everyone talks with and that everyone is compatible with to make more of these really cool devices available.
But yeah.
Interesting. It's very, very interesting coming in at $200. It's a little bit steep, but...
Yeah, right. Well, the original...
Said, go ahead.
Yeah. The original, as soon as I put it on Kickstarter, it was offered at $99. That went in several hours.
Yeah, I'm sure.
Then the next thing, I think, was $149. That went pretty quick, too. And now, I think it's, $199 online. Mm-hmm. And I think they were offering 500, and I think the 500 went very quickly, and I think they put another 500 in at 199.
And I mean, 200's cheap, steep. It's up there, but I remember having friends that bought, remember those Harmony remotes?
Oh, the Harmony remotes were $200 and $300.
Yeah, exactly. I'm on Logitech's website because I wanted to make sure. They have the Elite.
There
that's
you go.
$300 yeah. bucks. And
yeah.
then the
Reduced
Hub.
Reduced from $350.
Yeah, exactly. So the Harmony 950, that's right at that price point. And I feel like this is a more elegant thing than this remote.
Oh, absolutely.
So, interesting. Absolutely. Very, yeah. very interesting. Okay, well, okay. I think that was a great gadget, great find. Maybe it'll actually ship in 2017. Sorry.
And now, from something you want to something that you will, we'll ask the chat room there. We'll ask the men in the chat room, what they think of this. So let's take a look.
Hey, Dick DeBartolo, Maz Medist writer, and the Giz Wiz, one take theater here at gizwiz.tv, where CES unveiled. This poor guy got dressed in such a hurry, he has no pants on. Or is there a reason you have no pants?
Yeah, there's a reason. I didn't forget my pants.
Oh, you didn't? Oh, okay.
No. So why? Because we are selling underwear. But
you're selling underwear at CES?
Exactly. So, but special underwear. So
special underwear, okay.
So spot on is the boxer brief of the future. So what? Because this is a high-tech boxer brief that blocks more than 99% of all cell phone and Wi-Fi radiations. Because you have more and more studies showing the bad effects for your health and fertility when you keep your cell phone in your pocket. And for example, the Cleveland Clinic, who did a study, showed that men who keep their cell phone more than 4 hours a day in their pocket, they experience a 50% reduction in sperm count, and on the 50% remaining, the quality and DNA of the sperm are also impacted.
Okay. Now, does it
very
does
personal?
It feels
product.
Like yes. a regular fabric.
Exactly. So it really feels. Really wanted to have a stylish boxer brief, which is really comfortable, and so the technology we weaved silver fibers into the cotton of our fabric. And it acts like a Faraday cage to keep all the radiation outside.
Okay, there's no pocket in it where you could put a credit card you don't want anybody to see or...
No, we didn't do that, but why not?
In the future. Okay. Maybe in the future.
Maybe in the future.
Okay, and what are they gonna retail? Are they on the market now?
Yeah. We launched our website a few days ago. So we are already on the market on our website. SpartanUnderwear.com, and we'll be in CES in Las Vegas in January, and we hope to have retailers in the US market next year.
Next year. Oh, and the price point will be?
Yeah, so it's $47 for one pair.
Okay.
And the price goes down with when you buy more than one box.
More than one pair. Okay, well probably you need to get more than one because you have to send one to the laundry.
Yeah. Exactly.
Okay, Spartan. And Spartan Boxes. Dick DeBartolo, Mads Medist Rider, and the Giz Wiz, one take theater here at gizwiz.tv, taking my cell phone out of my pocket just in case. Bye.
I'm in for it. I got my cell phone right now.
Oh my gosh.
What are we going to do?
Well, you know, maybe in the back pocket is not as critical as the front pocket.
I got a glute in the way. Maybe it'll stop the radiation. I don't know, Dickie D.
I don't know.
This
either.
Seems like pseudoscience. Well,
let me see. Anybody in the chat room?
Pseudoscience, I say. Scam, says Marsworm. Okay. Does my phone... Okay, I don't know how much salt I should take with this, how many grains of salt, but I don't think that there is much radiation coming out of my cell phone.
Because you're not talking in your pocket.
Call me a non-believer, but I believe that cell phones work off of radio signals and not radiation signals. On top of that... I don't think silver weave stops radiation. Normally, fallout is radioactive particles, or even if you look at radiation suits, most of them are just plastic to keep the radiation fall off from touching your skin or being part of getting in your lungs or anything like that. And the ones that are made out of metal are normally just reflective to stop heat radiation, basically. So. Call me a non-believer, but I don't know.
I know. I'm not running out and buying these. I mean, maybe the metal in the underwear will improve your TV reception if you're watching TV on your phone. But
yeah, maybe.
I don't know.
Put your phone on your butt, you get a better signal than that metal. My tallest says yes. Radio and radiation. It's all on the RF spectrum. Same thing with microwaves and light. So if you're worried about light, there might be radiation coming at you from all directions. I don't know if I believe this.
Yeah, I'm not sure either.
I bet you they'll sell a ton of them, though. And now the people who aren't worried, they're going to buy it because they saw it here. So
we'll see.
Even bad publicity is good publicity.
Yeah, that's true. I'm going to do three more next week. But our final gadget today is for you, Chad.
Woohoo! Exciting.
When I went by and I saw this, I said to Dennis, oh, my God, we got to record this. I think Chad's going to be very interested in this. So let's watch.
Okay.
Hey, Dick DeBartolo, Mads Maddest Writer, and the Giz Wiz, one take theater here at gizwiz.tv. We're here at MSI Computer, and we're going to talk to Clifford. Clifford loves MSI Computer so much, he has one on his back.
Oh.
And it's a very special computer, and Clifford's going to tell us about it here.
Okay, so this one is our MSI VR1. We're actually debuting it today in here because we got 2 CES awards. So what's good about this is when you do VR, there's always cables around
you.
Yeah,
all the time. You trip on them.
You might trip over and hurt yourself.
He says
in here, because all the ports is right on the top of the devices in your back. So that way you will never have any cable whatsoever tangling you around. And then also what you can do is you can also put this next to your desk and plug a keyboard and mouse and function it just like a desktop.
Wow, that is really amazing. Now, how much battery power do we have? Because virtual reality uses a lot of battery power.
Yeah, so this unit itself, because it has 2 battery built in, and you can also do about 1.5 hours gameplay. And then what it does is, if you want, each of these batteries is also hot swappable. So you can actually hot swap and use this forever.
Oh, that's cool. So you have 2.
So each of these batteries,
so
you can just hot swap
one out
them.
While
and
one's still
you can
in.
Basically have extra batteries, and then you just keep on changing them and use it forever.
Oh, my gosh.
And Clifford, show the side of the actual computer to Dennis there while we talk about the price. So this is introduced today.
Looks like Thunderbolt,
and the price
USB-C,
range for,
HDMI.
It's called the VR1?
Yes, it's called VR1. So the unit is called VR1. We have 2 different options. Both of them come with i7. And the maximum memory is about 32 gig. The maximum SSD hard drive is going to be 1 tera. And you have 2 different options, one with 1060, that one is $19.99. And then there's another version, which is a $22.99 with 1070 graphic card.
Beautiful. And in there, we have a look at something here that will be out by the time we show this, but is actually a preview of the new Trident. So what's different about this?
So Trident is a console-sized full desktop power. What it is we actually use a full desktop tower devices and shrink it down into a little console size. The good things about this is you can do it like a desktop, or you can lay it down like a console. And then there's also VR port in the front, and also have ports in the back that you can hook it up to your TV. So you can use this as an entertainment system also.
Wow, and price range for the Trident?
So the Trident starts at $899, and it also can support 4K content.
Unbelievable. So that's MSI, and I forget, is it MSI.com or MSIComputer.com?
MSI.com.
MSI.com. You can get all the details there. This is Dick DeBartolo, Mads Maddest Writer, and the Giz Wiz, One Take Theater here at gizwiz.tv.
That is, I would have killed for a backpack computer like that when I was at Twit. And we were doing all that live coverage with that Live U backpack. I mean, that's really all was a gigantic, you know, computer strapped onto your back. That looks so much better, and it has two batteries, so you could easily swap between. The Live U had one built in, but it would last so short. It was such a small battery, and so you'd pull it out and then quickly throw another battery in there. That looks
And the whole thing is 7.5 pounds, which is
super light.
It seems for what there you go, is it has 360 virtual sound by I don't even know these people, powered by NAHIMIC and Double Shot Pro Thunderbolt 3. But I figured this is more. It's pretty neat looking.
It is pretty neat looking. And just having a backpack computer is, that's kind of a really neat form factor. And I really wonder what else, I mean, obviously VR. It makes total sense to strap this on. And I bet that, I mean, I could see this as being a big arcade hit and type thing. And almost like you go to paintball ranges and you know, shoot paintball. I could totally see going to a VR range, you strap into a backpack and, you know, go and do some amazing thing with it. I mean, just, this is so neat and flexible. And just putting a real computer, a really powerful computer, possible of doing VR on your back is so neat. This is just way cool. Give that thing a MiFi. Give that thing a hotspot, a 4G LTE hotspot. And remember the days of the 24-hour live blogging or live casting? Like, I'm almost more excited about just a computer in your backpack with hot swappable batteries than I am about it being for VR.
It seems pretty neat.
It seems really, really cool. That's a neat one.
All right. Good.
Awesome.
I'm glad that we picked something that we thought you would like, and you love it.
I do.
He doesn't like it. He loves it.
I do. And we have a theme coming up. We didn't plan this, but my crappy corner is pretty close to that backpack. So.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Well, that means, ladies and gentlemen, it's time for the final Chad's.
Chad's crappy corner.
So you have an under $5 VR backpack?
Absolutely. Actually, this is so funny. We didn't plan this. In fact, I haven't even emailed you what my gadget's going to be. A VR headset. For $5.
Wow.
So there's been a trend lately to use your phone as a VR screen.
Yes.
And so you can just buy VR enclosures. And I found this one at Five Below. And so I just had to check it out. First off, the VR headset looks pretty nice. It has some lenses, which had some plastic protection on it when I pulled it out originally. Has a hinge here to put your phone in, and it has a lot of itty-bitty little suction cups on the back. And that's really it. It has some straps to keep it on your face, some cushions so that it doesn't hurt your face. Cushions kind of coming off here. Push that back in.
So that can pretty much take any phone then, right?
Really, yes, exactly. Basically any phone. I have the iPhone 6S Plus. So it's the Plus is the large version, and it fits pretty nicely. This is about as large as phones get when it comes to this sort of stuff. So there's that. Before I try out the actual VR part of it, there are a few other things that come in it. There's, of course, the manual, which explains a little bit about it. But also some nice things in here are, this is a URL to follow to a large list of VR games, galleries, and apps for you to download on either the Google Play or the Apple Store. Got a free something else. But it also comes with a microfiber cloth and a little alcohol prep pad, which is kind of nice because I've seen people do this at press events where they'll clean out the VR headset in between people that use it. So it comes with a microfiber.
Oh, I see. Okay.
So, okay. I wasn't expecting these. That's so nice. So that is in there as well. So in order to set this up, go to the App Store, and there are plenty of apps. If you just search for virtual reality or search for Google Cardboard or anything like that, there's all sorts of stuff. In fact, Google Cardboard, this is done by Google, works a little bit with this app. Now, the Cardboard has a few extra features, one of them being that you can hit a button and accept. This does not have that, so there's no way to kind of reach in and press the screen or do anything like that with it. But you can launch a demo.
So the glasses don't have their own app at all. You just pick a different app from...
Okay. From, yeah. So your phone is kind of a completely separate part of this. Now, one thing is that the Google Cardboard app and other apps as well. Come on, we can do this. There we go. Oh, that's why. Here we go. I'm trying to brighten it up just a bit. They keep asking for a QR code. So if you hit switch to a different viewer, it gives you this little prompt, which is saying, find this symbol, it's a QR symbol with a VR in the middle, on your viewer somewhere. And mine isn't smart enough to have that. It doesn't have that QR symbol anywhere. It doesn't have it in the instructions either. So it isn't an actual Google Cardboard device. So there we go. All right, skip that. Okay, so now that it's in there, you can kind of see that it switches to a dual eye mode, and you can look around inside. So unfortunately, this is a little bit difficult to show off. Because I'll just put it on my face and check things out. But there's all sorts of different games and things to check out. This was a roller coaster and has an ad.
Ooh.
Yeah, this is an ad you got to get rid of. There you go. So now you're in a roller coaster. And it seems to work pretty well. So once you slap it in there, it has a clip on the top. Let's go ahead and strap it on my face. There we go. Okay, I'm looking out the back of this roller coaster.
Did your phone falling around?
The phone is a little bit kind of okay. The sticky things didn't really keep it in there all that much.
Oh, okay.
But with this large of a phone that I have, it seems to be working pretty okay. Of course, there's a few things. Whoa, that is very disorienting when the phone kind of tilts around. And also, I'm only looking out the back of this this thing instead of the front.
For your own info, Captain J says you can print out the Google Cardboard code on the internet, and it works.
Oh, interesting.
Yeah.
Huh. Well, it never stopped me from actually doing anything. It was more just like I was like, well, I feel like this isn't very compatible with it. But you can see that you know, it works pretty okay. There are a few things with these that you don't get with a HTC Vive or an Oculus Rift. There's a lot of extra movement that is calculated into the VR headset, like forward and backward movement. So if you kind of lean down, your eyes aren't just, you know, tilting down.
Oh,
it's a
little
disorienting, right? Because your head moves forward more on an axis. So it doesn't have any of that. But the cool thing is $5. You know, that's the real big takeaway from this is if you want to experience some VR, if you want to see some of it, you can experience it for $5, less than a cup of coffee.
Does it have a trade name?
A trade name?
I mean, like, I want to write about it on my blog.
VR mask, virtual reality viewer. Whoops, that's the, there you go. It really doesn't. It's from Electronic Necessities, and it says that it works with mobile phones. From screen sizes 3.5 to 6 inches. I did happen to find it on...
Oh, on Amazon?
On Five Below, on their website.
Oh, okay.
And there it is. That's the box I got. I think there was a really interesting... Have you ever listened to the podcast... 99 Design, no, not 99 Design, 99% Invisible. It's a design podcast, and they had a show recently about dollar stores. I think it opened my eyes to some of this and how the dollar store market has changed, you know, cities in China and things like that. Anyway, so I first thought that a lot of these were bought from tons of different warehouses. They just went into some warehouse. There's a lot of these laying around, and they bought a few of them. But after listening to that podcast, I actually think that a lot of these people make them specifically for that store. And so I now realize why I'm having so much trouble. I thought I'd go in, find it at Five Below, and that's because they existed everywhere, and... You know, there'd be other versions of it really cheap. But now I actually think the Five Below told someone to make this and to stock it. So anyway, I think that it's super interesting because even if you look at Google Cardboard specifically, the actual Google Cardboard, this is on Google Store, it cost $15.
Are you kidding?
No, this is a cardboard.
I thought Google Cardboard was free.
No, it's well, I think the designs are free. Okay. But, this single piece of cardboard is $15.
Oh, my gosh. Wait a minute. Hang on. That is so funny because I was cleaning something and I actually have a Google Cardboard.
Oh,
you know, I think they gave these away at a press event. Maybe that's what it was.
Right.
Yeah.
Right. Yeah, that's the New York
Times. Oh, no, I know. The New York Times.
The New York Times gave it to you.
Yeah, that was it.
Anyway, I think that it's a fun little gadget to play around with. $5 was the perfect price. And I'm glad that I got it. And it's kind of a fun little thing. It isn't... And I'm not trying to say this is like perfect quality. I mean, it's like a little flimsy here. The stickies on the on this, they're not attached straight on. They're kind of just slapped on there at an angle, and there's no way to kind of move them back.
Straighten
it up. So, but altogether, I'd say that I've been pretty happy with this VR headset for $5 from Five Below. That wraps it up for this month's crappy theme. If you are a patron, keep your eyes locked on Patreon so that you can vote on what next month's theme will be. Keep in mind, next month there are 5 weeks that we'll be doing on Thursday, but one of those we'll be doing our best of, worst of show. So I probably won't have a gadget then.
We should tell people if they could email us.
Yeah.
Something that they bought or something that they thought was stupid that we did in 2016. That would be great.
That'd be fantastic.
So that the end of the we're going to do it. I'm looking back here. We're going to do it on December 29th, and it would be fun. Chad and I can pick some of our own favorite best and worst. But it'd be great if you emailed mail at
Gizwiz.tv,
and just say, oh, I bought the thing that you guys showed and I loved it, or I bought the thing you guys showed and what are you, crazy?
And you guys are crazy for showing this up.
Any comments you want to send, that would be great to have sort of a family kind of best and worst of at the end of December.
Yeah.
So mail at gizwiz.tv.
Perfect. With that, let's move on to Nick's Gadget Warehouse.
They're geeky and they're goofy. Together they are loopy. When gadgets pass away, he takes them out to play in Nick's Gadget Warehouse.
Foghorn. What do you got for us this week?
Well, our viewer video is interesting because it's a first-time viewer video from David Podnar.
Woohoo! Good job, David.
P-O-D-N-A-R. And the funny thing is, he went to Five Below.
Oh, good!
And he bought something that I think is pretty neat. So let's watch David's viewer video.
Hey, Dick and Chad. Dave here. I was inspired to show you a gadget I picked up at Five Below after seeing Chad's tour of Five Below.
Woohoo!
I'm big into iPhone photography, but it's true of almost any smartphone that if you try to take a night shot, especially a sky night shot, it's really good to use one of the camera apps that give you like an extended exposure, but of course holding it's no good, and I'm cheap, so I'm not going to put out 50, 60 plus bucks for a tripod, which will hold it perfectly still. So I noticed at Five Below, they actually have something that's really meant for video, so you can watch it hands-free. As you can see, Gracie right now is...
Oh, hi, Gracie!
...the $5 clamp.
Perfect.
Here. Now, one thing that Cat the clamp model. Is also really good at is using a camera app where you can actually take
that
extended photos.
That is perfect!
Photos. And using a countdown timer, so you can actually take a shot, and let's say you wanted to extend your photo time a little bit here, so you don't want it to shake. So you can take your photo, let the countdown timer do its thing. You're not touching it, it's doing its own thing, and it takes its shot right there. That way, no shakiness, nothing going on. And at only Five Below, for a nice little clamp, you can actually put it lots of places, like on a fence or on a table here, to actually use it. And again, $5, very good. Thanks so much, and thanks so much for the show, guys. Have a great one.
That is perfect. That is so perfect. I'm glad I'm turned people on in this store.
Yeah,
pretty cool.
I'm jealous. There's not one anywhere near me.
Dang it.
David Podnar, thank you for that. And David, you will get the, you'll get December Mad, you'll get one of those 30-plus-year-old Alfred E. Newman pictures. And you want to look, Chad, and see if you can find that online?
The stand. Let me see.
The stand. If you can't, that's okay. And in the meantime, we need a video for next week, okay? We have a couple of videos, but like I said, we're looking for first-time video folks to send something in. It's very easy, as you saw Dave did. Just use your phone camera. Please use it in the horizontal mode, as David did. And he spoke up. So basically, as long as we can see the gadget and hear you talk, that's it. Put it on YouTube, and you can, just when you upload it, just click the little box that says unlisted. And that way, only people with the link will be able to see your video. We do put your link on the website so people can see it also. Go ahead. You were going to say something, sir?
I'm looking. I don't know. I can't see it. I see a lot of cell phone accessories, but not his clamp the website. I was also wanting to see where are their locations, if they had a big old map so that you could see.
They have a fair number. I know there are a couple in New Jersey. And someone in the chat room said one just opened near them. Lucky you.
Oh, man. Oh, yeah, here we go.
In New York City, we have a chain of stores called Jack's that is a little like Five Below. They sell everything in the world. I just bought 24 bungee cords for $4. of varying lengths. So it's sort of like five.
Holy cow, there's so many in Dallas.
Oh, look at
there's
you.
Tons of them.
That's not fair.
They're all over.
They're all in one place. Wait a minute. They all have the same number, don't they?
Oh, it's 5B for 5B.
They're all in Dallas.
I think it's only the ones within 100 miles of me.
Oh, I see. Okay.
But, yeah.
No, I think I saw a couple in New Jersey.
I need to choose this location.
Type in 10019 and see who comes up.
We go within 100 miles of you. Whoa.
Oh, there you see. Yeah.
Yikes, there's a lot of them. I didn't realize this was such a national store. Okay, get out of here. I don't want your directions. Oh, it's right over the... Oh, this is great.
Does that drive you crazy?
There's the X. There we go.
Oh, there it is. Okay.
So, yeah.
But
keep going in and in.
You see, and now New York has
nothing on Manhattan. Oh, there's something. One of these. Where is this? Oh, my gosh, this website. Zoom in there, wherever that is. It's pretty uptown. I mean, Marble Hill is where it's at.
Marble Hill. I'll have to ask Myra. She's probably close to that.
That's interesting.
Yeah, you got to cross a river even to get there.
Yeah.
It ain't in Manhattan.
That isn't. Nope, I don't think so. But it's good to know that they're around. I was worried it was a very local store, but that makes me happy.
So
that
when
it's
they
national.
Say Five Below, is everything $4.99?
No, it's five or below, and a lot of things are just
okay.
Yeah. It's also a lot don't have change, so it'll just say $1, $2.
Oh, I actually like that.
Yeah, exactly. So you don't have to sit there and think about it. Which
exactly. Okay. Nice.
With that, let's go on to the letter.
And a fan of the show from way back. You got the photo links, right?
Yep.
Okay, this is from Blue Green Yoshi. And the subject is Star Trek Phaser and Communicator. Dear Dick D and Red Sea. Oh, that's funny. Has anybody ever called you the Red Sea?
No, not yet.
Well, you have been. Dick D and Red Sea. I was out showrooming at Best Buy, and I found these two pricey pieces of nostalgia you might want to share on the show. First up is the Star Trek Communicator that connects to your cell phone via Bluetooth.
What?
You can use it to make calls, just like on the show. Pan down a little to the price.
Whoa! $150!
Second is a phaser that is set to stunning as it can control your TV as a remote.
Also $150.
He says both items are priced at way more than they are worth. But as pieces of nostalgia, they at least have a practical use. I hope they bring a smile to your face and a moth flying from your empty pockets. Yours in mirth and merriment, Chad Masters, a.k.a. Blue Green Yoshi.
Well, I really can't complain over that $200 remote control.
No, I was just going to say, how would you like to have this that can probably do channel up and down?
Yeah.
And possibly
maybe
volume.
And on off. Possibly.
And on off for $150.
Jeez.
Yeah. I mean, the communicator looks a little better because it looks like the old phone and you can make phone calls. But still, folks, $150. I don't think so either.
I mean, it'd be really cool. You're at the office. Your phone rings. and answer a phone call that way, but holy. Yeah.
Well, you know what you do? You buy one, you bring it to the office, you do that, and then you run back to Best Buy
right,
and say,
exactly.
Oh, so I gave it as a gift and I hated it.
My wife saw the bill and I just can't, I had to return it. I'm sorry.
Yeah. She said, oh, you got this at Five Below?
I said
no.
Try.
No.
Nope.
I got it at 150
times
below.
More. 30 times more. A little bit more. Wow. Well, that is some awesome stuff, Chad, a.k.a. Blue Green Yoshi. Thanks for showing that. And I think we all had the same idea. Take a photo of it while it's still in the store. Don't.
Yeah, there you go. There you go. A selfie.
No need to purchase
perfect.
It.
Perfect.
And we've come to the point of the show where I'd like to thank our patrons. Big thanks to you guys for supporting the show. This show is supported by its audience, and Patreon is the way we do it. Patreon is a platform for supporting independent content creators like ourselves, and we have our Patreon page at patreon.com/gizwiz, and we give a big thank you.
Oh my gosh, we're coming up to, let's see, this is our 82nd independent show.
Wow.
Which is directly attributed to the Patreons. We have done, Chad and I have no other source of income for this program except you guys. So thank you. And
thank you,
you made
so
our Thanksgiving by making this show possible.
Yes, very thankful for the patrons. Thanksgiving's tomorrow. Can you believe it? Man. So if you want to catch the show live, you can do so, gizwiz.tv. In the future, we should be back to Thursdays. No weird scheduling stuff for a little while at least. So Thursdays around 4:30 Pacific time, 7:30 Eastern time. There at gizwiz.tv. There you can join the chat room, chat along. We love the people in chat room right now. We have 52 people in there. This is great on a Wednesday, on a non-normal day. Thank you guys so much. And of course, if you missed the live stream, you can always download the show there. Check out the show notes or subscribe on iTunes or YouTube, or all the RSS links are there as well. Don't forget to play What the Heck Is It at gizwiz.biz. Not only does Dick write up nice articles about all the gadgets that we talk about on the show, but click on the sidebar to What the Heck Is It and get a guessin'. This is what we're trying to figure out what it is this week. And this is a light bulb remover for girls, obviously. I'm realizing after I said light bulb remover, that was what the gadget was last. Right. What the heck is it? But let me think. Oh, there we go. I know. It is a scuba diving helmet for Barbie dolls. There you go. Scuba diving helmet for Barbie dolls.
Okay.
If you have a better guess, get a guess and send an email over in the article right there. There's 12 Mad Magazines for correct answers if you really know what it is, but 24, and sometimes more, for funny answers, hilarious, creative, and punny answers as well. So
yes,
get a guess.
Punny. We like punny.
We like punny. We do like the puns. And with that, I think we've wrapped it up for this show. Thanks so much for watching. We will see you next week.
And I'll be here.